started with a burglary alarm around 2:30 this morning in Clyde.
And it quickly turned into a chase out of town that damaged two squad cars and led officers south to New Virginia, where the suspect abandoned the getaway truck. KCCI's Mark Tauschek is live right now at Seven Flags, where this crime all started.
Well, the general manager here at Seven Flags told me today this guy had a lot of guts to try to pull this off. In the end, he got away with nothing, but he certainly caused a lot of problems along the way.
After breaking into this large concert venue and opening a garage door, the suspect drove the truck he had just stolen from a nearby business into place, threw it in reverse, and stepped on the gas.
There he goes. Booyah.
I'd like to catch him, but no, I'm sorry.
The GM at Seven Flags showed us security video. You can see the thief loading the two ATMs, although watch this, he loses one not 100 feet into his getaway. That's when a Clive officer responding to the burglary alarm shows up, and that's when the thief makes his way out of the garage door and rams into two squad cars, disabling them both. From there, a third Clive officer gives chase, following the truck southbound into the northbound lanes of I-35. Clive's police chief says the action is going to be reviewed, but his initial assessment is the officer was correct to give chase going the wrong way.
At least with those warning lights, people coming northbound had some indication someone was on the way.
The man drove the wrong way over 30 miles to the New Virginia exit. At some point, stop sticks damaged the truck's tires. He lost control on a rural road, crashed the truck, and took off running, sparking a search that focused on a square mile area of fields and timber just west of New Virginia.
I hope he wasn't going to come this way. It was kind of creepy.
Charlotte Wickett's son has been keeping a lookout from the family home just across the street from where the search was focusing. Charlotte says she'll be locking her doors until she hears he's been captured.
It was exciting. We don't normally have any excitement like this anyway.
That search was called off around 11 this morning. The man has not been found. Reporting live in Clive, Mark Tauschek, KCCI 8 News, Iowa's news leader.